By the end of this video, you'll know how to make a sizzling demo reel in Filmora 9. Check this out. Hey, I'm Elliot from Filmora, here to empower your inner video creator. Before we talk about demo reels, it would be amazing if you subscribe and hit that notification bell, and while you're doing all that, give us a like as well. Okay, on to demo reels. If you're trying to promote yourself as a video creator, an editor, or anything creative, then it's a great idea to have a demo reel. A demo reel is a montage that highlights your best work and shows off your style and skill set. It is a way of telling the world who you are and what you do. Here are 11 do's and don'ts of creating a demo reel. Number 1. Do start with text that includes your name and creative title, whether that's cinematographer, animator, videographer, or even content creator. Number 2. Don't use unlicensed copyrighted music. You don't want to risk having your demo reel taken down due to a copyright strike, and using someone else's music without permission will look very unprofessional. YouTube has a wide selection of free approved music that you could use in their audio library. Number 3. Do use your best work, and only your best work. This reel is for highlighting the most impressive things you've done, and the entire reel should be amazing. Number 4. Don't take credit for work you didn't do. It's dishonest, and it'll hurt your reputation when people figure it out. Number 5. Do keep your reel short. 90 seconds or less is a good length. You want to end it while the viewers are still thinking, "Wow!" before their mind has a chance to wander. Number 6. Don't repeat any footage. It makes it look like you haven't had enough experience to fill a full demo reel. Number 7. Do make a text note on your shot to clarify your role. If your reel includes footage of different types of work, for example, videos you directed but didn't edit, or videos you edited but didn't direct, make sure you clarify that. Number 8. Don't include any errors, whether they're spelling, filming, or editing mistakes. Even if the mistakes in the footage isn't made by you, like if it's an audio error and someone else recorded it, it's still good to remove the footage so it won't distract from your work. Number 9. Do you use projects that you love doing and work that shows off your personality? Even though you might never meet your viewers, your reel should tell people who you are and what you want to be hired to do. Number 10. Don't forget to include your contact information and the URL of your website or portfolio in the text at the end of your reel. It's also a good idea to put a thank you for watching there to show your viewers you appreciate them for taking the time to look at your work. Lastly, number 11, do start strong and finish stronger. Start off with footage that hooks your viewers in, something surprising, and end with footage that leaves your viewers wanting more. Something that evokes emotions. There you go. Those are 11 do's and don'ts for creating a demo reel. Have you ever made a demo reel? If you make one in the future, what is one clip that you know that you want to have included? Let us know in the comments below. I'll see you next time. Keep creating.